The value in speaking the word goes to the value of the word itself that you're speaking. What is the value of speaking God's word? Let's get into this. If you would look at 1 Corinthians, hopefully you'll have your Bible with you today. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 20. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. So this was God's method. He is pleased by this method. And according to this verse of scripture, it is his method. It's what pleased him, so that by the foolishness, what the world calls foolishness, there's no foolishness in it, but it went by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. Well, what is preaching? What is preaching but speaking God's word? Preaching is speaking God's word. You have to open your mouth and say something. That's what preaching is. Preaching is speaking God's word. So by speaking God's word, the end of speaking God's word is to save them that believe. Well, save is a very interesting word. If you look it up in the Greek, save, the word is sozo. It means to deliver. To deliver you from something that's bad. So God's method is to speak God's word, and through the vehicle of them speaking words, God's words, then salvation or sozo will take place. A deliverance will take place. Another way we could translate sozo is to heal. It's encapsulated, it's like an all-inclusive word for taking you out of what's bad and putting you into something that's better. So to be delivered from sickness would be healing, right? If the sickness you had was taken away, then you are in health. Does this make sense? Okay, so through the foolishness of preaching, or through the foolishness of speaking God's word, you can have sickness taken away from you. Isn't this good news? This is great news. You can be delivered. You can be delivered from sin. Delivered from sin? Yes, delivered from sin would be living now in righteousness. You can be delivered by the foolishness of preaching, or by the foolishness of speaking God's word. You can be delivered from an eternal home in hell. How would you do that? By speaking God's word. You can be healed. You can, another word for sozo is to make whole. And to do well. Do you know what do well means? It has to do with financial things. So God can prosper you through the speaking of his word. And we're going to get more and more into this, but I wanted you to see that. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching, or of speaking God's word, to save, sozo, them that believe. Now, you can be delivered from all kinds of things. Sometimes it means delivered from even people. By speaking God's word, listen to me, you can be delivered, and you will be delivered from people who are holding you back and trying to keep you in bondage. It's a matter of you learning how to speak God's word. You're delivered from sin. You're delivered from hell as an eternal home. You're delivered from all sickness and disease. You're delivered from poverty. You're delivered from debt. You're delivered from devils and evil spirits. Right? The main word for sozo is deliverance, and it means so you can be delivered from evil spirits. Are you telling me I can be delivered from evil spirits that have been plaguing me just by speaking God's word? Yes. What I'm telling you. The value in speaking the word goes to the value of the word itself that you're speaking. So if the value of the word that you're speaking is by Jesus' stripes I was healed, well, that's the value of it. It will go all the way to by Jesus' stripes you are healed. If the word is my God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus, what's the value of speaking that word? The value of speaking that word will take you all the way to my God supplies all my need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Is there value in speaking God's word, or what is the value of speaking God's word? This great value. Complete deliverance. Well, what about, you know, evil spirits? No, evil spirits too. You get delivered from them by speaking God's word. Go over to 2 Peter and let's look into the reasons why there's so great value placed here. 2 Peter chapter 1 and verse 19. We also have a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well that you take heed. Well, what a take heed means, number one, you hear it. Now, either somebody else is speaking it to you, or you can speak to yourself. You ever speak to yourself? I encourage you to do it, and do it a lot. Why? Because you can't always have a preacher with you, but you could have somebody, you, preaching to yourself, you speaking God's word. You do well that you take heed as unto a light that shines in a dark place until the day dawn and the day star arise where? In your heart. So you're going to take heed to the word going into your ear, and then the day star light is going to arise on the inside of you. Where? In your heart, in your spirit, man. And what happens? That's when belief takes place. Remember, belief doesn't take place in your mind. Belief takes place in your inner man, in your spirit. It's a spiritual function. Verse 20, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is even a private interpretation. Why do you think he has you know that first? Because the first thing that's going to come up to your head is, well, that's not for me. This verse of scripture isn't for me. This promise isn't for me. This is for somebody else. That's the first thing you got to get over. No, this prophecy or this verse of scripture, this promise of God written in his Bible is God speaking to you. And then you take that verse of scripture and you take heed to it by listening to it, and it goes down into your inner man and causes belief. If you're low on belief, guess what you're low on? You're low on hearing the word, which means you're low on speaking the word, because you can't hear the word without speaking the word. Verse 21, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of men, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. So who were they moved by? They were moved by the Holy Ghost. It wasn't their will, it was the will of the Holy Ghost. So every verse and promise of scripture is God the Holy Ghost, who's God in the earth today, God the Holy Ghost's will for you. Know that, and know it first, that it's not just for somebody else, it's for you. So when you see by Jesus' stripes you were healed, it means you. God gives me power to get wealth. God gives who power to get wealth? God gives you power to get wealth. You know, my spiritual dad, Kenneth E. Hagin, said, you know, you have to speak three times as much on the speaking of God's word as you do on the believing of God's word. And there's a reason for that, because through the speaking comes the hearing, and through the hearing comes the believing. Well, the believing is just an after result of the speaking and the hearing. And if you concentrate on speaking and hearing, the belief just comes. We'll get to that in a little bit. Faith comes by hearing. It just comes. You don't necessarily have anything to do with that, other than the fact that you have to make sure you're attending to God's word, you're giving heed to it, and you're hearing it through speaking it. 2 Corinthians, chapter 4 and verse 13, having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed and therefore have I spoken. We also believe and therefore speak. I believed and therefore have I what? Spoken. We also believe and therefore speak. There is no believing outside of speaking. I hope you heard that. Because you want to have more faith, you want to have more belief. You can't have more faith, you can't have more belief outside of speaking God's word. Where do you think faith comes from? Faith is encapsulated in these promises. We have the same spirit of faith. Now, who's the spirit of faith? That would be the Holy Ghost. So when the Holy Ghost moved on people to write things in his Bible, the Holy Ghost's Bible, then he encapsulated the spirit of faith in every word. It's in there. If you could break down each word and look to the molecular structure of every single word that's in the Bible, it has faith on the inside of it. Your job now is to have the same spirit of faith by taking that word and believing it by speaking. Believing by speaking. Believing by speaking. So what happens when we speak? Let's say this is fine. Okay, God gave us promises, and I'm going to say I'm going to have the same spirit of faith. I'm going to speak it and believe it. I'm going to believe it. I'm going to speak it. I'm going to speak it. I'm going to believe it. I'm going to be in agreement with God, walking with God, agreeing with God. He wrote it in the Bible. He's the spirit of faith. We have the same spirit of faith. So what happens when I do that? This is going to help you out. What happens when I do that? Verse 17, Romans 10, 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So faith, which is a product of your inner man, your spirit man, cometh by hearing the word of God. Well, If faith comes by hearing the word of God, there must be faith in God's word for it to produce faith in you. So if I hear the word, it goes into my ear, it goes down into my spirit, it's carrying faith with it that reacts in my spirit. This is God's method. It's God's method of transferring his faith into your spirit. You know, everybody gets stressed out over this. I don't have enough faith. I don't have enough faith. How am I going to believe for this to come to pass? I want this scripture, but how am I going to believe it to come to pass? You're going about it all the wrong way. You're not trying to believe it to come to pass. You have the same spirit of faith as the one that's putting the faith in you. The problem is you haven't been putting enough faith in you. You haven't been putting enough word in you, because the word is what produces the faith to bring itself to pass. God's method is to transfer his faith into your inner man. So whatever scripture, by Jesus' stripes I was healed, there's faith in by Jesus' stripes I was healed. God himself, the Holy Ghost, put his faith into it, the same spirit of faith. Now we simply have to take by Jesus' stripes I was healed, hear it, and have it go down into our spirit and produce the results. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, which means God's faith comes. Because if you're hearing the word of God, what faith is going to come? And where's it come from? It just comes from somewhere. See, I heard the word of God. It just came from somewhere else. No, it came from the word of God. So when I hear the word of God, and then that faith comes through my ear and goes into my spirit, man. Jesus said, and I don't know if we'll turn over there because I don't want to run out of time here, Luke 9:44, you can look it up later, let these words sink down in your ears. Remember him saying that? Let what sink down in your ears? Let his words sink down into your ears. Down where into your ear? Into the inner part of your ear? No, down into your inner man, into your spirit man. And he also said, he that has ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying. Right? Over and over he'd say that. But what are we doing? We're hearing the word of God, and we're letting that word sink down. Psalms 45:1, my heart is inditing a good matter. I speak of the things which I have made touching the king. My tongue is the pen of a ready writer. My tongue is the pen of a ready writer. I don't have to have somebody else preach to me all the time. I can preach to myself. I have a tongue. Which means I can write the word of God through my ear into my own man, inner man, by saying the word of God. What value is there in speaking the word of God? That. I speak the word of God, and my tongue is the pen of a ready writer. I'm literally writing on my inner man with the faith of God and his word. What will the faith of God produce? Well, the faith of God produced, and his word produced, everything that you're standing on right now, and therefore it can rearrange everything. See, when it becomes your pen, your tongue is the pen of a ready writer, it opens to you unlimited faith, and you're only limited by the amount that you're willing to write. Write where? Write on your inner man. Well, now I'm gonna write my, by Jesus' stripes I was healed. And when I say that, what happens? Faith comes. Why does faith come? Because I heard myself say it. I heard those words, by Jesus' stripes I was healed. And when I said that, faith came. It went down into my ear. It sunk down deep into my ear, and it went into my inner man. What did? God's faith. Not your faith, God's faith. 1 John 5:4. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world, and this is the victory that overcomes the world. Wouldn't it be great if God told us what the victory was that overcomes the world? Well, this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Well, where do we get our faith from? And I hope I can get this across to you. You don't get your faith. It's not your faith. I believe, I believe, I believe. You get your faith from God's word. Faith comes by hearing. You can't have faith apart from God's word. So you have to get your faith from God's word, which is his faith. Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. We have a statement that we say, we like to say, what in the world is your problem? at least here in the United States, what in the world is your problem? This is the victory that overcomes the world. Whatever the problem is in your world, we have an answer to it. There's an answer to that. 2 Corinthians 1:20, all the promises of God in him are yes. Ever hear that? People say, well, you know, God sometimes says yes, sometimes God says no, sometimes God says wait. No, God always says yes. You're the one who's saying no and wait. You're the one that's not saying his promise. Because as soon as you say his promise, the faith that's in that promise begins to react on your inner man and cause belief. What is the value in speaking God's word? The value in speaking God's word is directly proportional to the value in the word itself that you're speaking. It will produce itself in your life because that word contains God's faith, God's will, and when it goes in your ear, faith comes. You're only limited by the amount that you're willing to speak your word, his word, and hear his word. Romans chapter 10, let's look at verse 6. But the righteousness which is of faith does what? It speaks. The just shall live by faith. The righteousness of faith speaks. Why does the righteousness of faith speak? Well, because over in verse 17 it says faith comes by hearing, and hearing, and there's no faith apart from hearing,
and there's no hearing apart from speaking.
But the righteousness which is of faith speaks. Look down to verse 8. But what saith it? What saith the righteousness of faith? The word. The righteousness of faith speaks. What saith the righteousness of faith? What saith it? The word. The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. It's in thy mouth first and in thy heart. How do you suppose it gets from your mouth to your heart? The righteousness of faith speaks it. And when you speak it, you hear it, and it goes down into your heart. What's going down into your heart when you hear it? Faith cometh. Whose faith? Your faith? No, you end up having faith, but it's God's faith that goes into your ear. When you speak God's word that's full of faith, God's word that's full of faith goes down into your ear. And when God's word that's full of faith goes down into your ear, it gets down into your inner man where belief can take place. And whatever it is that you've been saying by the Spirit of God and by his will, which is his word, will come to pass in your life if you will continue to say it and you don't get sidetracked by saying and thinking other things. So continue on in speaking God's word. Continue on in saying the promises of God, and you will see miraculous things come to pass, things that couldn't happen any other way. For this is my method, says the Spirit. This is my way of transferring my faith to you so that we can walk together in the earth. Let me finish this up here. Go down to verse 10. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, with the mouth confession is made unto. With the mouth, confession is made unto, and look at that word, salvation. It's the same word that we began with, the word sozo. And the word sozo means to deliver, to heal, to make whole, to do well. Basically, whatever you need, deliverance from or to. Confession is made unto that. So you don't stop until you have the thing that you're confessing for. This is the problem. People stop. By Jesus' stripes I was healed. Why did you stop? Well, then you go back to the beginning and you say it again. And you say it again. Confession is made unto. And every time faith comes by hearing. That's why he said faith comes by hearing and hearing. If God just wanted you to hear it once or say it once, he would have just said faith comes by hearing once. But that's not the way it works. And you remember, you're only limited by the amount you're willing to speak God's word and hear God's word. Every word of God has the ability and the faith within it to bring itself to pass. You don't have to, oh, I gotta believe. You can't do that. It doesn't work that way. You've got to speak. You've got to speak and hear. And as you speak and hear, God's faith comes and rises up on the inside of you. And that's why you wonder, well, I don't know, I just believe it. I don't know how I believe it, I just believe it. Well, how did that happen? Because you're so brilliant? No, it's because God's faith came and began to rise up and work on the inside of you, and nothing is impossible to you who believe.